Hello children, very warm and delightful welcome to Effective Learning Hub. Now I am going to discuss with the first lesson of class 6 English from the textbook Honeysuckle. The title of the poem is A House, A Home and it is written by Lorraine M. Halley. It is a short, beautiful poem. Not only, it is a very, very meaningful poem. Before starting the poem, I would like to ask you one question. What is the difference between a house and a home? Do you know the difference? If you don't know, no problem. Let me ask another one question. Why do you live in house or in a home? Okay, if you don't know, no problem. After reading this poem, you can understand what is the difference between a house and a home. First, I'll read the poem. After that, I'll explain each and every line separately. What is a house? It's brick and stone and wood that's hard. Some window glass and perhaps a yard. It eaves and chimneys and tile floors. And stucco and roof and lots of doors. What is a home? It's loving and family and doing for others. It's brothers and sisters and fathers and mothers. It's unselfish acts and kindly sharing and showing your loved ones you are always caring. Okay, now I'll explain the poem. Okay. This poem starts with a question and the poet is asking what is a house. Okay, first I'll read it. What is a house? It's brick and stone and wood that's hard. And you all know house is made of brick, stones, cement, wood and so many other things. And according to the poet also, house is a structure which is made of bricks, stones, woods that are hard. Wood is used to make doors. Next line, some window glass and perhaps a yard. Again he says, it is not just about the structure which is made of bricks, stones, then wood. It also has windows. That windows is made of glass and perhaps a yard. Perhaps means maybe. Yard means an open area or open space in the front of the house or backside of the house. Now, why the poet has used the word perhaps? Perhaps means it is not necessary that every house will have a yard. A house may or may not has a yard. Alright, next line. It's eaves and chimneys and tile floors. A house has eaves. Eaves means a part of roof that hangs out over the wall to provide the shade. Or we can say it is the elevation of the roof. That eaves protect the house from rains and sunlight. What else it has? It has chimneys. Chimneys is a hollow structure which allows the smoke to escape from the building, or it is used to carry off the kitchen smoke into the sky. Next, and tile floors. The house also has floors which is made up of tiles. Next line, and stucco and roof and lots of doors. Stucco means fine plaster used for coating wall surfaces. And roof, we all know every house has a roof. And house also has lot of doors. Okay, this is the description of house given by the poet. Then, house is a structure, just a building. It has no feelings, no emotions. It's all a non-living things. Okay, now let's move on to the second stanza. Okay, what is the first question that the poet asked? Yes, it is, what is a house? Now, what's the second question that the poet asked? Yes, it is. What is a home? Here, the poet explains the nature of a home. And also he explains what makes a house a home. Okay, what is a home? It's loving and family and doing for others. It's brothers and sisters and fathers and mothers. Okay, home is made of family, a loving family, and doing acts for others. It is made up of family, and that family is made up of family members. Who are all the family members? Brothers, sisters, fathers, mothers, and grandparents. Some of you may be living with your grandparents, so they are also the members of your family. Next line. It's unselfish acts and kindly sharing and showing your loved ones you are always caring. It is not only made up of family members, but their acts without any selfish interest. They love and care for others. They concern for others. They wish to work for others' happiness and well-being. They wish to show love and care for others. In this way, a house becomes a home. For example, your parents will do lot of things for you. Your mother cooks food for you. She cleans your clothes. Your father earns money for you. These are unselfish acts. They are doing all these things because they love you. They care for you. Your brother and sisters share things with you. I hope you share your things to your brothers and sisters. Yes, home is nothing but it's all about the family members. Their love, their concern and sharing towards others. So, home is made up of loving and caring family members. So a house is just a structure. So the family members make that house into a home by loving and caring attitude. I hope you got an answer to that question, that why do you live? Yes, we live in a home, not in a house. Okay, thank you students. If you like this video, share this video, comment this video, and subscribe this channel. Thank you.